This week on the Shtick, we have with us as our special guest, Lisa Farber. I'm going to ask Lisa, what's your shtick?
Well, Henry, I am head of WITSO Aviv in Australia, which means I'm the head of WITSO for young people, people under 50 generally. And we're reinvigorating WITSO and having lots of young girls and women become involved.
It's a wonderful organisation. It's been going now for 88 years.
That's true. We just celebrated 88 years, had a big gala dinner at the Crown Casino, which you were there. And, we're going full steam ahead.
Yeah, I filmed the whole event, except I missed the beginning because I got caught in the car park.
Yes, everyone else.
Crown Casino car park. It's frightening. But I got there and there were some fantastic speakers. We had Ted Bailey speaking.
He was great. And the fact that he knew so much about the WITSO projects indicates just how, you know, prominent WITSO as an organisation is.
Mm. And he did a lot of research.
Yeah, he did.
Knew about Sderot.
He did.
And
the troubles there.
And the satellite TV station that we're having problems with.
Yes.
And but overall, the guest speaker, Yuval Aviv, was a very interesting person.
Very interesting and very provocative. I think the fallout after he's spoken, people are not quite sure what to make of it, whether we should be as alarmed as he indicated. But he did point out some serious problems within the community that we should pay attention to, because we are vulnerable.
We are indeed. And that's one of the things that WISO looks after, is especially the vulnerable children in our society.
That's it.
Who come from dysfunctional and abusive families. Tell us about the project in Israel that you're doing.
Well, one of WITSO's projects, we have quite a few, one of the shining lights is a project called Achuzat Yeladim. And what it is, it's a home in Haifa where children from troubled backgrounds can come and find refuge and be rehabilitated so that they can re-enter Israeli society. Most of these children go on to do the army, which, as you know, mm-hmm. is a pivotal point in Israeli growing up. And what happens is the children there are given a pet, perhaps, to look after, to learn caring, or they each are given a social worker or someone to look after them, to guide them out of their troubled times and see them enter Israeli society as well full-grown individuals.
Fantastic. And all the money that gets raised all over the world goes to Israel?
WITSO operates in a number of different countries, as far away as Norway. There are girls working for Israel, and all the money gets sent to Israel and to work on different projects. Some of the projects are in Haifa. I recently visited one in Jerusalem, where there's a creche for young children, as well as a shelter for battered women. So WITSO really runs the gamut, looking after the elderly, looking after immigrants, offering hotlines and training facilities for women, and the emphasis really is on women and children, which is why it appealed to me so much.
Fantastic. Yeah, women have been getting quite a big run lately, especially with Hillary Clinton.
Absolutely.
And now we have Sarah Palin, who's coming in on the other side,
yes.
Which is a real... I think it's an amazing coup that John McCain has pulled off here,
yes.
That he's found that he's actually gone really left of centre, although she's as right as you can be.
Yes.
So she's pulled someone from that side, and she's, like, really hardcore, completely behind the Republican cause.
Yes.
So it's going to be a very interesting
election.
Interesting. It's going to be
and
really
especially if we listen to what Yuval Aviv mentioned, how there might be something to destabilize Barack Obama, then, you know, we could be in for a McCain victory.
A la Spain, which is what happened
let's
there.
Let's hope not. Let's hope
not. Yeah, I know. And we're hoping that Barack Obama is safe from all those rednecks. That's the other problem
That's
we're going
true,
to be
true.
Looking at as well, because, you know, we know what happened to John Kennedy and Robert and all, you know, like Martin Luther King. And I have fears.
Really?
Oh, yes. I think anything can happen, but I think he's going to get major security happening for him.
Yeah, look, I hope, you know, we need a strong America, and America's a huge supporter of Israel. And the equivalent of WITSO in America is Hadassah. They do the same sort
it's
of work.
It's not called WISO in America?
It's not called WISO. Not that I know of. I know in Britain it's very much a Commonwealth thing, with Britain being called WISO and Australia. But they work tirelessly for Israel in America. A lot of the organisations, and a strong America in favour of Israel is important.
And they always will be, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Well, Lisa, it's been really wonderful having you on the
show.
As
it's
our
been great.
Special guest this week.
And, thank you.
There really is cause to celebrate women and children. and life. And we're just about to embark upon the Jewish New Year. That was, I think, the other night was the last 60th anniversary, because everybody's done the 60th anniversary.
And now the year is officially nearly over with Rosh Hashanah.
We're looking forward to Rosh Hashanah.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Wonderful. Thank you, Lisa.
Well, have you ever been asked to be a hostess to one of these?
No, I'm mortally offended.
I was worried you'd be offended, because when I speak to Lisa Faber, I'll ask her to organise it for you.
To be a hostess?
Yeah, because all it takes is you've got to give them gelt. Put the shaitel on and give them gelt.
Lily's been asked to be a hostess, but I mean, you know.
She's refused.
I think she's done it a few times.
I don't like it, because it doesn't really mean anything. It's like, you look through the list, who do I know and what level?
You grew up in Turek, so you'd always be a patron.
Yes. I'm also half Hungarian, half Polish. Why does it always have to come back to this?
It does. You have to be a patron.
Comes back to this.
Yeah.
Is we
it's undone by means test, right? Because you are seen to have a little bit more than usual, you're automatically a patron and also passenger. If you give money pertaining to how much a hostess can afford, people will just talk about you, because they know you've got
more.
It's
all linked to the international Zionist conspiracy.
That's
Rizzo
right.
Makes up two of the words, that. International Zionist. See, there's I'm not a conspiracy theorist. But
the coven theory is
attractive
to you. But if the show
doesn't go on, you'll understand why.
Barry disappears and not on the couch next week.
You'll be at the
bottom
of the hole.
We'll see you after the break anyway.